Hi, John here from Boxcars One Objects. You might remember that we use math shakers for a lot of things in math, but one of the things I like to use math shakers for is fractions. So let's get started. These activities are in the book Math Shakers Upper Elementary. And when I have two shakers like this, I have a top row of, this is my top row of dice, that's my numerator. The bottom row of dice is my denominator. And what I can do is I can just name the fractions. So I have 5/3 greater than 1. 5/2 greater than 1, 3/4 greater than 1, 1/4 less than 1, actually 3/4 is less than 1, 1/4 is less than 1, 1/6 is less than 1, 3/2 is greater than 1, 5/2 is greater than 1. I love the way I self-corrected here, and you'll see kids doing the same thing. We can go look. Equivalent fraction here, this is 5/3, that's the same as 1 2/3. 5/2, that's 2 1/2. 3/4 is 3/4, 1/4, 1/6 is 1/6. 3/2 is 1 1/2, and 5/2 is 5. If I can line them up from least to greatest, I have 1/6 is the smallest, followed by 1/4, followed by 3/4, and then I started getting into numbers greater than 1. So this is 1 2/3, this is 1 1/2, 1 1/2 is my, so 1 1/2 is my next smallest, or next largest, followed by 1 2/3, followed by 2 1/2, and finally followed by 5. And so lots of activities there. We can take that and we can record our work. For example, we have 5/3, we have 5/2, we have 3/4, we have 1/4, we have 1/6, 3/2, and we have 5/1. Now, that equals the number 1, that equals the 1 1/2. This is still 1/6, this is still 1/4, this is still 3/4, this is 1, actually this is 2 1/2, and this is 1 2/3, and then we can start to line them up from least to greatest. 1/4, nope, actually 1/6, love that self-correction again. 1/6, 1/4, 3/4, and then I have 1 1/2, 1 2/3, 1 1/2, 1 2/3, 2 1/2, and then 5. And so just a great activity there. And I love fraction action. We can actually take it a little bit further. We can actually start to use 1 to 12 dice. And when we do 1 to 12 dice, we have a whole wider or much more advanced kind of way of doing fractions. So here I have 7/12, 4/10, 3/7, 2/5, 9/1, that's 9. We have 9/5, and we have 4/9. And we can record that work like this. We have 7/2, we have 1/4, we have 1/11, we have 2/5, we have 9/3, we have 9/5, and we have 4/9. And same thing here, 7/2, that's the same as 3 1/2. 1/4 is 1/4, 1/11 is 11th, 2/5 is 2/5. 9/3 is the same as 3. 9/5 is the same as 1 4/5. And finally, 4/9 is 4/9. And again, we can line them up from least to greatest. It looks like 1/11 actually is our smallest. Well, followed by 1/4, followed by, it looks like 2/5. Then we have 1/3, and followed by 4/9. Well, 2/5, 4/9. Which is bigger? I think 4/9 is slightly bigger than 2/5. 4/9, yeah, yep, slightly bigger. And then we start getting into our whole numbers. We have 1 4/5. Then we have 3. Then we have 3 1/2. You can see even as an adult, I kind of struggle with that. And I just have the kids work with that. It's just really good fraction activity there. And we can talk about terms like proper fractions, improper fractions, regular fractions, irregular fractions. But the terms I like to use is 7/2 is a fraction whose value is greater than 1, 1/4 is less than 1, 1/11 is less than 1. 2/5 is less than 1. 9/3 is a fraction greater than 1. 9/5 is a fraction greater than 1. And 4/9 is a fraction less than 1. And so we can also talk about mixed numbers. I have 3 and 1/2. It's a mix of whole numbers and fractions. So just lots and lots of different fraction activities we can do. Hopefully you enjoyed that. And I hope to see you at another video soon. Bye now.